Cinnamon, where you gonna run to? Cinnamon, where you gonna run to? Where you gonna run to? All on that day, will I run to the rock? Please hide me and run to the rock. Please hide me and run to the rock. Please hide me, Lord, all on that day. But the rock cried out, I can't hide you.
Now, could you tell us a little bit about your academic background? See, Spelman College, University of Iowa, Arizona State University. How has each one of these institutions contributed to your career, to who you are now? I have a special interest in Spelman College. How does that work?
I love Spelman College. Spelman College is a university where all the students are black women. It was founded in 1881. Actually by a pair of missionaries who had actually fairly strange ideas about what they wanted this school to be. But it has evolved, and it was at Spelman College where I realized that I could be a writer. It's where I first met not only other women writers, but other black women writers. I met them in person, and it became something that was very possible for me. And after that, I went to the University of Iowa, which was a very cold and lonely place. It's like I went from Spelman, where everyone was a black woman, to Iowa, where no one was except for me. And then many years later, I just quite by chance, I got a scholarship to go to Arizona State University. I met a woman in an elevator. I'm very tall, which you can't tell because I'm sitting down, but I'm very tall. And this woman was very short, and I didn't see her. I didn't see her in the elevator, and I knocked into her, and I thought I had killed her. I felt so terrible. Like, oh no, I'm this tall person, and I've just killed a small person. And you know, I said, I'm so sorry. And I told her my name, and she had seen the one story I had ever published. And she said, she talked very excitedly. She said, come to Arizona and work with me. I'll help you. I'll be your mentor. And it felt so meant to be because I had just started working on my first book and I didn't know where to turn. And then I accidentally almost killed someone that directs a creative writing program. So I moved out there and worked with her one-on-one, and that's how I was able to write my first book.
Excellent. Do you know why? I mean, did you expect your I think we always have this expectation. Did you expect Leaving Atlanta, Beyond Telling, to be so popular while you were writing it or right after it was published?
I didn't know what to expect. I mean, when I wrote my first book, you know, no one in my family is a writer. I didn't know what happened. I wrote the story because it was in my heart. I didn't know what to expect next.
Right. You didn't write for the prizes, right? For the awards. You wrote because you wanted to make it known, maybe.
It's impossible to write for the awards. Because I think in many ways, right, publication and trying to find your audience, it's like trying to find love. You can't make it happen. You just try to be the best person you can be and hope, you know, you find someone. And I think writing is like that too. You write the best book you can write and you hope it connects with someone. And you don't know when it'll happen. It can happen right away, as soon as you publish it. It can happen, you know, many years later. You don't know. The only thing you can control is that you write the best book you can. When you write a book, all you really want to do is, as my professor used to say, you want to survive the draft. You feel like you're almost like you're drowning, you're just clawing for your life. And that question is almost like, when you're trying not to drown, do you wonder what you look like? Like, no, I don't. I feel that it's like that with writing, that you're just so, you just want to finish it. Because a book can die on the vine. It can die. It can just, I know lots of people, they work for a couple years on a book and they just lose that thread. So you're just trying to keep it alive. That's what you're doing. You're not imagining who's reading it. You can't think about the critics. You just really want to get to the end in one piece.
And what else have you had published? Do you have papers or do you write for journals?
I sometimes write kind of personal essays, memoir essays, but only when I'm forced to. It's not my impulse to write true stories, but sometimes there'll be something that I care about. For example, the Atlanta child murders case was reopened. They wanted to reinvestigate it, and I was in favor of that. So I wrote a fairly long piece on why I thought that should be reopened, because I care about that. But I mostly get to these novels and just stick with them. It takes me about 4 or 5 years to write one, but I love it because for 4 or 5 years, I always know what I'm doing. You know, I know every day, just trying to finish that novel. And I like having the commitment to the one project. Some people like to write short pieces, but I like to just get there and stay there.
And do you believe that writing is an innate ability? Are people born with the tools to become a skillful writer, or is it that anyone can develop, I wouldn't say equally, but similarly?
I think that the key to being a writer is you work really hard and you sacrifice your social life. You know, that's what it is. There are a lot of people who are very talented, but they don't work hard and they want to go out and play all the time and they don't write. And so they have a beautiful talent, they have a beautiful gift, but they'll never publish. And then there are other people who, like, I wasn't the best writer in my class, but I was the hardest working writer in my class. I had something of a talent, but it wasn't the kind of talent that people would, you know, spot. Like, I was not the teacher's favorite. The teacher wouldn't say, oh my God, this girl is amazing. I don't think anyone had their eye on me as being the one who would make it, but it was the only thing I wanted for my life since I was a child. And I just worked toward it. I mean, since I was 10 years old, and it paid off for me. And I think that's the key. I think you need some talent, but you need to be stubborn. You need to be really, really stubborn and just keep working at it. Always. I went 10 years between when I published my first story and I published my first book, and I was only about 29. So that was half my life with no good news. Not one piece of good news, not one acceptance, nothing. And then in the year 2000, everything started happening. I was winning prizes, my book was published, I was traveling, but for 10 years I just had to do it with no positive, you know, reinforcement.
Professor, you want to ask a question?
Could you name two current U.S. authors you particularly like in their books?
I am obsessed with Toni Morrison to a level that is not healthy. I love her. I think about her all the time. And another living author I like is actually, there's so many good books being written right now. But I like a writer called Valerie Martin. Her book is called Property. I thought it was amazing. I think that she's like a very, very talented, underrated author. I think it happens a lot. I think sometimes you read a book and it's so good and you can't believe that it's not famous. And that's when you realize that you can't care about fame. Because I think every writer, you know someone that you write better than him and he is more famous than you. And you know someone that they write better than you and they're not as famous as you are.
You said you had in the classmates that you considered were better writers than you were, do you know if any one of those better writers are as successful as writers as you are now, maybe more?
No. They didn't work hard.
They didn't work out of that.
They didn't work hard. I mean, you have to work unreasonably hard to be a writer. If I meet people and they say they want to write, the real question always is, can you live without it? If they say no, if they say yes, I can live without it, you tell them, go do something else. Because it's just such a difficult thing to do. You have to really love it, in addition to being talented. You have to really love it. And I think my classmates, although talented, they liked it, they didn't love it.
And I learned that you have finished your third book, and you're working on your fourth book. Can you tell us about that?
My third book is about a man who has two wives, and this is what I think. He has two wives. The one wife knows nothing, but the second wife, she knows. Because I think that if you want to pull off a double life, one woman has to help you. So it's really a story about the woman who knows and her daughter. Because if you think about it, the one who doesn't know, she's boring because she thinks she has an ordinary life. But the one who does know, her life is not ordinary at all. So it's really about her and her daughter and the way that they explain to themselves that they are not keeping a secret, they are a secret.
And it has been published?
Not yet. I just finished it last month.
And you're working on your fourth book already?
I am working on my fourth book. And I can't tell you about it because it's too new, but I'm excited about it.
And you don't sleep much.
No, who needs to sleep?
Spend the night writing.
That's why they have coffee.
Right. I'd like to really thank you profusely for being here. It's been a pleasure. It's been an education. Thank the consul, the American government represented here by our friend Ed Palomorin. Thank you for being here and stay till the end. I know you have a tight schedule and we've found a fit. Thank you very much. And would you like to, do you have any email you'd like to give us, or you can leave it with us and then we can pass it over?
And well, my email also is just my name, TyariJones@gmail. I have a theory that you can reach almost, at least in the U.S., you can reach anyone under the age of 50 by sending an email to their name at gmail because everyone uses it.
Okay. All right. Professor, final words?
I'd like to thank you on behalf of the board for sharing your marvelous experience. I remember, was it John Keats that said that of all the arts that in which the wise excel, nature's chief masterpiece is writing well. And that's what you've been doing.
Thank you so much.
So thank you. Thank you, everybody. Thank you very much.
I can't hide the rock right out. I ain't going